So let me go ahead and try to explain what's going on. And as I said, Professor Curley and I are incredibly excited about this class and incredibly excited to meet you. If you would imagine something for me, you can think about a coil that I might make out of a piece of wire. So I'm going to draw it on here in red. And I apologize for my drawing skills. And I might inject a current into that coil, if that makes sense. And so it goes around the wire and comes around the front and then goes around the loop and comes around the front. You know, does that make sense to everybody? In other words, I'm trying to draw a spiral that kind of spirals around on the paper. Is that cool?
Yes, thank you, Steve.
And I'm going to imagine that I drop a magnet into it. So the magnet is just like you might have poked on your refrigerator, but it's going to have a north pole and a south pole, not really, but it's exactly like the one on your refrigerator. And that makes a magnetic field. And that magnetic field, by convention, we usually think of as coming out of the north pole and going around to the top and closing back on the south pole, if you guys follow me. Now, that's a very simple situation. It's just a coil and a magnet. In fact, I actually have it. So I'll show it to you over here if I pop cameras. Hold on a second. So if I were to take a look on my bench here, what you'll see is, sorry, let me zoom in there. I actually have a coil of wire almost exactly like what I was just talking about. And I also have a magnet. So these are neodymium magnets. And I've marked the magnet with a little Sharpie on it so I know which side is north and which side is south. And I'm going to back this up and put the magnet in the coil exactly the way I just drew it on the paper. So if I drop that in, it's kind of like the Civil War muzzle loader, if you know what I mean. It just sort of puts that magnet down into the bottom there. And if I go back to the paper for a second, excuse me, let me try not to lose my camera. So if I go back to the paper for a second, what you see is, if we think about that, there's a wonderful piece of physics that governs this situation. It tells us that there's going to be a force on the wire that's equal to the current times the length of the wire times the magnetic field. That's a miracle. That observation is the basis for modern civilization. And I can use it actually to figure out which direction the forces will be on the wire. So we'll talk more about that in class, but I'll tell you that if you have a field coming out this way and a current going around that way, you can, for example, use a physics trick called the right-hand rule and figure out that for this situation, the force on the wire is going to be down, which is really boring. So in other words, if you think about that, it's not terribly exciting. The wire coil is already sitting on the table. So if I have a force going down on it, that's awfully boring. It's just going to push it harder into the table. But here's the cool part. Newton, there's an equal and opposite force on the magnet. So if the wire is being pushed down, the magnet's being pushed up. And let me show you that. So if I come back over here and turn on my mobile cam, and we take a look at this setup again, I'm going to take this system with the coil and the circuit that's here, and I'm going to connect it up. Remember, the magnet's inside down there. I'm going to connect it up to this battery. So now I have a source of power. And if I connect the power to the coil, I can launch the magnet. Everybody see that?
Yes.
That makes sense? Outstanding. Yep. So let me come back for a second. So the point I'm trying to make is this. Our week over the summer is an intensive look at the physics forces that make things like electric motors, like in a Tesla, or in the vibrator that's in your phone, or any number of other things, anything that uses electricity to make force. We take a look at that. I'm sort of the control and power electronics guy. Jim Curley, my partner, and also my mentor, the guy who taught me most of everything of what I know, is Tesla, basically. he's not here, so I'll swallow his head. He's the master of the electric field and magnetic field, if you follow me. And so what happens over the course of the week is we will do a very deep dive into understanding the physics of how electromagnetic actuators work. Car door locks, motors for pumping water, generators in windmills, the whole deal. And we will do that at a level that, as I said, I'm really talking about Professor K. He is understands these machines in a way that you can actually probably count the number of people in the world living who understand them the way he does. So it is something where we will be using MATLAB and computer tools or Octave probably this summer, which is a MATLAB clone, in order to model, simulate, and understand how these machines operate. We will also be doing things like we're going to not only send you the software, but also a hardware kit. So you're going to see a microcontroller like this one. That microcontroller, this we won't be sending you quite this much junk. This is just my demo, but we will be sending you a small motor like this one. So you'll be able to look inside, see the windings, and understand how that works. And then we'll be connecting that up to a circuit that you will build, for example, in the middle day of the class on Wednesday, and then be able to create something like this. So if I plug in my microcontroller into my USB port here, that's going to power up the whole system. When I do that, you can see what the micro is doing right now is making that motor turn, if that makes sense to everybody. And I can actually control the speed of that. So if I find the right pot, I can make that go faster or slower. That's just one of the afternoons building that hardware. Most of the time is spent in a really deep dive, understanding the machines and modeling them with computer tools. It isn't easy. If you're excited about this, there's no other experience like it. As I said, there might be five people on Earth right now, like Professor K, and I'm Igor, his assistant. So we're looking forward to seeing you. If you're excited about the kind of things I just showed you, we think this is a pretty unique experience, and we're looking forward to seeing you for the week over the summer. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve. That was excellent. That was really fun to watch all of those gadgets. Thank you for preparing that. That was really amazing. Thank you.